Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Dolls. With this new format, we return this time with the penultimate video of the Persona 5 custom series. Yes, as you heard it, penultimate video. Many people on Instagram asked me to make a Sumi Yoshizawa from Persona 5 Royal, and well, I couldn't refuse the idea, so the answer was a definite yes. Kasumi will be part of the series, being the last member of the Phantom Thieves and the last video too. Now returning to the correct video, this time is the turn of Goro Akechi, aka Crow, the charismatic detective and also known in the fandom as Pancake Boy. Goro is the 9th and temporary member of the Phantom Thieves, and those who have played Persona 5 or seen the anime, they know what I mean by temporary. So, I will not continue giving explanations since I don't want to throw any spoilers to anyone who doesn't know it. In personal words, his design or respect to his costume stand out quite a bit, as most of the Phantom Thieves have their darkest clothes, and I say this because his suit is completely white with a color palette of red and gold that at first glance is very elegant. As always, on my Instagram I share the concept art that I made of the character, since it's a good way to visualize every detail that the character has, be it small or large. And well, without more to say, let's get started! For the base, I will use a Dexter Charming from Ever After High, as I did with the other male members. This is the last doll I have of him, and I reserve it especially for this project. The first thing I'll do is remove all the hair so I can work on Akechi's hair. Very well, I already had the head clean. As always, I will not remove his face from him yet, since I will do in one of the next steps later. For his hair, I want to reuse the leftover hair wax from Noir's video, but I realized that the color was very light, so I decided not to use them. So I bought this ball of yarn that more closely resembles Goro's hair. And when I'm making the wax, they give me a better result, especially with the color. With that, it's time to do his hair. As always, I do a wake up off camera to have it ready. And I start gluing the hair wax from the bottom up with the help of a brush and white glue. Now I'll finish filling the top with more hair. And we already have all his hair glued to the wig cap. Oh my god, if I put a hat and glasses on it, it looks like Cousin It from Adam's Family. Well, I found his face. Now with an old wet toothbrush, I will flatten it a little to be able to get the shape of his hairstyle. And just giving a few cuts with small scissors. With a brush dipped in glue and water, I will make the shape of his hairstyle faster. When doing anime hairstyle, anyone wants to get the style as close as possible how the character has it. Well, unless you are a perfectionist just like me. And we have Akechi hairstyle finished from back to front. For double protection, as always, I use a hair fixer. And it's ready. And I don't know why it reminds me a little of Zac Efron. I think it's the doll face, who knows. Now with the hair done, it's time to make his mask, which Goro uses to call his persona Robin Hood. I covered the entire face with plastic and masking tape to be able to draw the shape of his mask with a pen, and then put the Apoxie skull in the entire marked area. With the help of my silicone tools, I will take out more the shape of his mask and also to mark his details. To make the bird's beak, I cut a piece of plastic in the shape of a triangle that I bent in half. It is only a matter of putting on where the nose is marked and merge it with the clay so that the stage fits it. Now I will continue giving more details with my tools. The Sleeping Crow's Mask. Already in this shot, I glued the elastic around it. And this is how it would look on the doll's face. At first glance, it looks incredible. With that, I'll start to paint first with a white base for the beak. And then paint it all in red. To protect the paint, I will cover it with a layer of Ultraglass varnish. And inside with a layer of matte varnish. And we have Crow's Mask ready. The gloss here will make it look better. And with that, let's move on to my favorite part of the entire video, the repaint. Very well, with the doll's face ready to use, I will erase it with a cotton cloth dipped in pure acetone. By passing two coats of Mr. Super Clear Spray, I start to draw the first line of the shape of his eyes using a light watercolor pencil. With that, I draw his pupils giving a little more detail. To then draw his eyebrows making two dots as a guy. Already with the lines of the eyes drawn, I will fill in it with more colors. Then I will pass in chalk pastels to some areas of his face to give touches of shadows. With that, I continue to fill his eyes with color. This time to color his pupils with red. And filling it with more dark tones for the shadows. Some skin tones helps a lot to delineate the lines of the eyelashes and achieve a better delineation. Now I will use a black pencil to be able to mark the lines of the eyelashes more. The good thing about drawing male faces is that I don't have to complicate so much with the eyelashes since there are always one or two lines. This color also helps a lot to define more the shadows of the pupils, as you can see in these shots. I'm done with the pencils, it's time to use the paints. I painted a white line for the tail of his lips to highlight the smile that I drew. Now with black, I'll pass a little on his eyelashes. With a little red paint, I will highlight more the color of his pupils to finish it with the shine on his eyes. As always, I protect the eyes and lids with a layer of Ultraglass varnish, avoiding the black dots of his eyes. And this is how Goro's face looks. I must say that he looks very attractive. Now let's see how he looks with his hair on. Wow, seriously, putting this on him changed a lot. With his face finished, let's move on to make his outfit. As you can see, I already have the patterns marked on the fabric. When I looked the concept, I noticed that the color of his outfit has parts in gray, so the fabric that I used, I dyed in the same color. I just had to join everything with the needle and thread, and we will have the base ready. Staying this way. Sewing all this by hand was seriously very exhausting, especially sewing the white ribbons in the middle of the slits and the red edges. The same was also when I sew his pants. As you can see, the edges of the ribbons, I will also sew it a strip of yarn for more details. And with that, I can move on with the rest of the details. The golden rod that you see, I will sew it directly on the slits. And I will pass white glue to secure the seams. After that, I paint what I saw with a layer of gold so that the colors stand out more. I put a masking tape so that the line is more even. And I continue giving decoration with paint. The pants only need a few small decorations on the bottom that I paint with gray. Now I will do the next step. Crow's outfit has these decorations that resemble lace, and to make them to scale, first I'm gonna mark some dots with 3D paint one by one. And then I will paint them with gray, so that they also mix it with the yarn strip that I saw. With my sculpting tool, I will mark some white dots for more details. I had never marked dots in this way, and the truth is that doing it is more easier for me. And this is how the decoration of his suit looks. It looks wonderful with everything I add, including the pants. This is how it will look on the body of the doll. I just had to join this part with the needle and thread, and it will be ready. Now with this red fabric, I will sew his cape. Staying this way. Off camera, I painted decorations in gold on the part of his neck. For his shoes, I decided to reuse these that I had stored in my stock box, and that I was modifying a little with Apoxie and craft foam to give their exact design, and then give them more light with paint. And this is how they look. To make them look shiny, I give them a small layer of Ultraglass with a little of water. For the rest of the pieces, such as his epaulets and his belt, I made them using craft foam with an A on each one. I think the A is for Akechi. Next, I will give them more dimension with 3D paint. And then paint them with several layers of gold. And decorated the inside with red paint for, you know, details. Then I continue this time with the bell. To clarify, the buckle is the one I made of craft foam. The rest is just a ribbon. Thus leaving cross epaulets and bell like this. I went to a local store in my country and I was able to get this for the fringe of his epaulets. I just had to glue them around with the help of my silicone glue. And this is what they look like. They look good, but they need a cut. To have a better result, I use the tall shoulders to guide me when I'm making the cut. I have cut that part, and with that, I will guide myself to cut the others. With all the pieces of his outfit ready, I will assemble each one on the doll's body. With that ready, now I will be gluing the decoration on his chest that I made off camera. And that's how they look. The only bad thing is that I had 2 pieces of this left over, and he on his suit has 7, and he only gave me space for 5. Well, I think it looks good, and if I put others, it was going to be too much. To finish with his outfit, I will paint his hands in white to make the gloves. I will also give them a layer of pearl paint, since I felt that passing white is not enough when gloves or this color are painted. And with that, Crow's outfit is finished. Wow, I love how everything looks, it looks so elegant, for real. In the end, I made his weapons in the same way as the rest of the Phantom Thieves, using wood, a little epoxy, and giving them a good coat of paint with details on each one. And with all that, Crow is ready. I am very, very satisfied to achieve a result like this. I think what I really liked the most was making his epaulets, since they give a unique touch to his outfit. And not to mention how I made the expression on his face. Wow, who would say, appearances can be deceiving and more with that smile. And it seems that Joker has found his other half. Thanks for watching this video, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to my channel to see more content like this, and also follow me on Instagram to see previews of upcoming and future videos. God, I cannot believe I'll say this, but well, our next and last Phantom Thief to come is Violet. My name is Eric and I will see you next time, bye!